China has been up to a lot of things lately when it comes to its space program. If you are wondering what they're working on currently and where they're headed in the future, then you have come to the right place. In today's video, we will look at China's secret plans to build a moon base and much more. Stay tuned. Welcome to Futured. Make sure to subscribe to our channel to get updated with everything on future technology, Elon Musk, or SpaceX. Let's get started. The foundation for China's explosive return to the space race in the 21st century after decades on the back burner has already been established. In 2003, China relaunched its space program by launching astronaut Yang Lee Wei into orbit, but that was only the beginning. In fact, a good old space race is about the best thing that can happen in terms of technological growth. The rise of the aerospace industry from the Silicon Valley came out of the military-industrial complex of the 1950s and 1960s, which had led to major investments in intellectual pursuits for both the US and USSR. By the mid-1960s, 4% of the US government budget was going into space exploration, and that got them all the way to the moon with computer technology alone. But China wasn't going to sit back and play a spectator. China and the Soviet Union. When President Dwight Eisenhower threatened China with nuclear weapons in 1953, China was a kind of unheralded contender in the initial space race. Chairman Mao was not a man to take things lightly. When Mao saw Russia launch their Sputnik satellite into space in 1957, he replied by initiating his own nuclear program. Mao also decided to start his own space program. China is widely thought to have entered the space race for reasons other than supremacy or triumph, as the US and the Soviet Union did. China was only the third country to achieve independent human space travel as a result of this. Consider this: while the rest of the world was relying on NASA's space shuttle, China decided to go on it alone, utilizing the Long March 2 rocket and their SHENZO 5 spacecraft, and it was only the first step by 2007. By 2011, China had sent a spacecraft into lunar orbit, so you can clearly assess the speed of growth. They launched a prototype space station called the Tiangong 1 into Earth's orbit in 2013 and landed their first rover on the moon in 2014, making them only the third country to do so. In 2016, they launched another prototype space station called the Tiangong 2, and their astronauts successfully lived in it for 33 days. In the 21st century, China's space program rocketed off much like a rocket, and almost no one noticed, especially not the US. George Bush was justifiably preoccupied with a perplexing war on two fronts, while Barack Obama simply didn't care about space. During Obama's presidency, the space shuttle program ended with nothing to show for it, and America lost its ability to reach space on its own. President Obama famously said that he didn't care about going to the moon because America had already been there, so why bother going back? As a result, we essentially got the aerospace equivalent of a tortoise and hare story, where America just sat back and did nothing while China came up behind them and passed them by until President Trump came along. The space race. Before we go any further, say what you want about Donald Trump, but the man loves space. Not only did he launch the Space Force, which is essentially a rebranding of the Air Force Space Command, but he also launched the Space Force, which is essentially underway on an international level. Vice President Mike Pence was famously quoted as saying, "Make no mistake about it, we are in a space race today, just as we were in the 1960s, and the stakes are even higher." He said this in 2019 at a meeting of the National Space Council. Just months prior to the meeting, China had landed yet another lunar rover. The US government had good reason to be concerned about being overtaken in the final frontier just a year after Pence's speech in June 2020, when the final satellite in China's Baidu network was launched. This satellite navigation system is newer and more advanced than the United States' global positioning system. The civil version of Baidu is supposed to be accurate to 10 meters, which is roughly double that of GPS, and the restricted military version is claimed to be accurate to 10 centimeters. In 2020, China's space agency launched 39 missions to deliver payloads into orbit, compared to 44 for the US, and it did so while spending about one-fifth as much money on space exploration as the US. In 2021, China launched the core module of the Tiangong space station into orbit using a Long March 5 rocket. This isn't another model. This is the first stage of a new permanent Chinese space station, which is significant because China is not permitted to utilize the International Space Station. Remember how we claimed the US did a "you can't sit with us" routine? In 2011, the US government formally blocked Chinese astronauts from visiting the ISS, despite the fact that the term international is literally in the name and that the station is a collaborative endeavor involving five space programs from America, Russia, Canada, Japan, and the European Union. This implies that the US should not be in charge of the entire project, which in hindsight was probably not the greatest decision. ISS. The ISS is fast deteriorating and will need to be decommissioned within the next 10 years. There is now no definite plan in place to replace it, therefore the old guard is vanishing. The Chinese station is being built on a modular platform that can expand over time to become whatever they want it to be. The first phase of the Tiangong will only be about a quarter of the size of the ISS, but it will be much more efficient in its use of space and power. The Chinese station's solar system should prove to be a major improvement, allowing the station to use electric ion thrusters to maintain its position in orbit. The current ISS burns about 9 tons of rocket fuel per year to maintain its own position, and the Tiangong is even planning its own telescope with a high-powered camera that will probably outperform the Hubble telescope in terms of image resolution. Obviously, the Chinese can now turn to the Americans and say, "You're not allowed on our space station," which would be a major problem. Of course, the US will build their own, even more advanced gateway station out in orbit. It's all a little disheartening. This is not how we get Starfleet. This is how we get some terrible, crazy future like the Expanse. Now, that's not to say a space race is a bad thing. In fact, a good old space race is about the best thing that can happen in terms of technological growth. So how do we proceed from here? China's latest rover, which landed on the Red Planet barely 2 months ago in 2021, is currently on a long-term exploring mission to Mars. China is now only the second country to send a rover to Mars. Others have tried, but everyone except the US has failed to get their rover to work until now. And if China accomplished it once, don't think for a second that they won't do it again, and who knows what they'll send next. It's been rumored that China is working on something similar to the SpaceX Starship Super Heavy vehicle. Call it a rip-off of a Starship if you want, but if it works, it implies China is landing a lot more than remote control vehicles on Mars. Then there's the moon, where no one knows what China's rover is up to. Whatever it's up to on the dark side of the moon, whatever it's up to is merely the first stage in a larger scheme. NASA may think the gateway station in orbit around the moon is brilliant, but word on the street is that China and Russia are collaborating on a moon base. Building on the moon's surface, and if we had to guess why, we'd say it's probably in search of an element called helium-3. Helium-3 is a rare element on Earth, but it appears to be abundant on the moon, and it has a lot of potential for use as a nuclear fuel in fusion reactors. That, I'm sure, has a lot to do with why Mike Pence felt such a strong desire to get back into the space race. There's now something to lose in the space race, and being the first to establish a foothold on the moon could be a solid first step toward becoming the new superpower on Earth. Of course, none of this would matter if the space race never resumed. So what do you think? Is China poised to take over space? Will they beat NASA to the moon? Share your thoughts in the comments area below. That's all for now. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel to get updated with everything on future technology, Elon Musk, or SpaceX. Thank you for watching.